So, good afternoon. So, as it was said before, I work within Etrix Collaboration, which is a collaboration aiming at developing services and to increase the efficiency in translational research. So there are many work packages within Etrix. There are packages that are working on legal issues, on standards, on data reuse, on development within Transmart and other applications. And there is a work package that is working in order to provide the infrastructure and the good design for the platform to enable the users to use it as easily or as user-friendly as possible. So I will concentrate on this part of the Etrix. So here is the presentation of the general architecture of the Etrix platform. So you have somewhere the users in a kind of a nebula there. And basically, you have the hardware that was set up for Etrix, on which there is a cloud. The layer is an OpenStack cloud platform. And we will build the module on top of this platform. So the main module that we have built is a module that I call here the Etrix Project Modules, and that will be the main module. Sorry? It's okay? That will be the main modules that enable the users at any level of their use to be able to work with the data or to work with Transmart. So basically, this Etrix module has a curation instance, which will be devoted, of course, to the people that have the rights and the privileges to do the curation on the data that they are provided with. So this is the curation instance, and then you have the Transmart instance, which is the Transmart instance with the data and with the application itself. So of course, all this project module is based on hardware and software applications and disk and virtual machines. So you have various kind of storages that store the data at its different level, whether it is the raw data or whether it is the database, the data that is in the database, for example, the Postgres database for Transmart instance. I forgot to tell you that this Transmart applications is an open community and open source, which means that we work with the Postgres databases. And it was one of the developments that was made also by the work package too, to transform Transmart to be able to use also open source databases. So all this module is based on these services that you see. You have R in the middle. In fact, it is we have made some kind of multi-threaded VMs in order to handle the R applications separately from the Transmart in order to ease the computation and the usage of Transmart. So we have also LDAP here, the directories that give authorization and privileges to the different users depending on their level, whether they are simple users or whether they are curators or whether they are people that are able to delete data or not delete data. Okay, so the users, whatever the user is, and the user means anyone who is going to access the platform, it can be very privileged users or very simple users, the users will access to the service here. I don't know if the, okay, good. Will access to the service always either through some kind of protected gateway, SSH gateway, for the people that are doing privileged things within Etrix, or through web gateways on the Transmart instance. So you have seen this module. This is a complete module. And in order to help to go fast in bringing more projects to Etrix and deploying more easily the structure, the infrastructure, In fact, this module is a complete module, and it is this module that is cloned in order, for example, to serve the public server that I will talk about later on, or any of the projects that want to have their own data and their own module totally independently and privately owned by the project. So this is an easy cloning. Each time another project comes, we can open for him a full instance. You see at the end of this training, we also have very often trainings to the user at any user, at any level of training, and we deploy as many modules as it is needed depending on the number of users. Okay, so we have also a lot of collaborative services that we provide to the users. Public website, GitLab, operational portal. I forgot to mention one because I heard a question before in the talks. We have, for example, ticketing system that is very, very useful in order to exchange directly with the user. In case he has a problem, he sends a ticket, and then we can immediately find who is the best person within Etrix to answer his or her question. Okay, so those are the collaborative services. Recently, by recently I mean 1.5 to 2 years ago, we have been developing another foot of Etrix, that is the Etrix Labs. We want to give the chance to the people that have developments or new applications or anything that is in beta mode to be able to have their Etrix, their application deployed on a real good infrastructure, powerful infrastructure, and with the help of people. So we have, with the help of experts to deploy their application. So for this, we have developed this Etrix Lab module, which contains the backend of the Etrix Labs, and the applications that the user wants to develop or to provide to other users. So this in the same way, each time another user comes, we can provide him with a platform that is more or less the same as for the other ones. We customize it, of course, to the need of the application and of the users, but basically we have the system already prepared for that. Okay, so that was the concept of the platform. I will talk to you about the public server, which is mainly the main demonstrator, and not only demonstrator, it is the public server that allows us, each time there is data that can be made public, it is made public on this public server. So, the public server and all the tools and applications that Etrix provides to the user can be accessed directly through an operation portal, where you can see here on the top, for example, the public server, which if you click on it, you will access it immediately. And then you can have the documentation that has been compiled and prepared within Etrix, and then you have the access to the platform of all the hosted projects, and you have the service and tools that I showed you before. So the public server by itself is running, of course, Transmart, and the version 3 of Etrix flavor of Transmart has been released in September this year. This version of Transmart is running Transmart 16.1 and already with Smart R inside. It is running on the Postgres open access database for the data storage. And we have a multi-threading at R level in order to improve the performance of Transmart. And so far, we have 58 studies curated and loaded within this public server that you can all access if you wish. Okay, now We have presented quite extensively the standard Etrix last year. I will just concentrate on this new part, that is the Etrix Labs. So the Etrix Labs, we have actually several applications at various development stages. And what is the added value of Etrix? Because everywhere you can find part of this application. The added value is that we have really good resources that can allow the application to run smoothly and great. We provide a support for the deployment of the application. It means that system administrators or bioinformaticians will help the user to deploy its application. We have a support for the optimal hosting with an advice on what is the VM that you should use, what is the database that you should use. And we try to provide some kind of harmonization for the documentation, the hosting, the deployment for all this application. And of course, we have open data sets in these applications. As I told you before, there is a dual single point to access the labs. It is either the main website, etrix.org, or the portal.etrix.org that is really devoted to the services only. Okay, let's make a turn. This is the portal, and these are all the Etrix labs that are deployed so far. I will come to this later. But what you can find here for each Etrix Labs is the access to the application or to the access to the demo if the application is not yet at that level. You can find the application somehow in free source. You can load it yourself. You can find, clicking on the picture, you can find the documentation and you can find a demo. So, these are the different applications that are deployed so far. Of course, SmartR. I have put, whenever possible, the name of the person, for example, here, Adriano, that will present it much more extensively than I would ever do. And so you know all that it is a dynamic and interactive visualization and analysis of data within Transmart. And actually, it's the first time with this version 3 that SmartR is on Etrix platform, fully integrated to the public server with the latest Transmart in hand. So we have also WGC-NA to study the correlations between the probe sets and gene expression data and compare it with clinical data using the method, the WGC-NA method. We have also SNF, an iterative method for constructing patient similarity networks and integrating them after that in a common network. It is the same toolbox that is grouping these two applications, because they are both powered by Shiny, and it is R-based applications with a web interface. So HiDOM also is deposited within Etrix platform, and Denis Verbeck will talk about it because he deployed it. So HiDOM is used to create patient cohort subsamples by setting constraints on components of high-dimensional data sets of omic data. So it is there and you can try it and use it. You have also this is knowledge base, and this is to construct a repository to provide biological context from experimental studies for the IMI project or even beyond. So it is of course two Etrix labs. One is this is networks, and the other one this is map, and it is based on a quite new graph database approach, Neo4j. EHS. Unfortunately, the talk was at the same time in the first session in parallel, but you can always go to the slide. Ibrahim is the promoter of this Etrix harmonization services, and it's a huge application platform for data harmonization and support for cross studies, data investigation, and it is of course based on the standards for data harmonization, and it improves and extends the capacity to treat new data and make it available to Transmart. And there are two in preparation, GSVA and EAE. You can hear about EAE by Axel. I think it's tomorrow. And so here GSVA, so gene set variation analysis to estimate the variation of activity over sample population in unsupervised approach. This will be added with the other set of Shiny application, namely SNF and WGCNA, and will soon come. And EAE is a very ambitious analytical environment to manage large data sets for data analysis that has Transmart as a front end, and there is already a proof of concept version installed for demonstration. So I have tried to put the technical tools on which it is based, part of it at least. In summary, I would say that since its launching, Etrix has been continuously growing. It has been hosting the public server with large open data sets and with up-to-date Transmart applications inside. And it has been serving projects on demand for hosting and support. We have, for example, AB Risk or OncoTrax projects onto the platform. Now, since 1 year and a half, Etrix is evolving into a multitask platform, adding the component that is called the Etrix Labs. It is a very interesting incubator for new applications to develop and reach larger audience. It is a provider of large and state-of-the-art resources. Etrix provides for this help, support, training, and contacts with the developers. And some of these applications, of course, later will be fully integrated to the Transmart application. Thank you.